Everybody, let's do this. G-G-G unit. Welcome to the West Coast. Say CD. Believe me, you want to know all about losses. I'm from Compton, where the wrong colors, be cautious. One phone call, I had your body dumped in Marshalls. I stay strapped like Carson. This is an adult video blog. Nigga Rob got killed for his wrong, please. Go for adults, okay? This is AZD, Arash the Part, motherfucking D-Bazaar. This is an under entertainment. That means I'm gonna say and do whatever it takes. Rated X, rated R, baby. Stay away unless you're an adult. Walk your kids through it. Maybe you want them to learn some of this stuff, especially today's subject. I think it'll be important to you. Also, let's see what else. You're responsible for your own condition while watching this, and remember to spread the word. I'm back, all right? Let everybody know. Let all 11,400 subscribers know. Go tell them. A lot of people know. From the beginning to the end. My mouth has been shut, so I can't really rap. I put my teeth together. And then I rap like 50 Cent. If I put my teeth together, don't open my mouth. My mom's happy, she ain't gotta pay the rent. And she got a red bow on that brand new bench. Waiting on shot money to land, sitting in the range. Thinking how they spent $30 million on airplanes. All right, let's talk. How are you going to approach life is the way you're going to approach your crush. Okay, how to approach one's crush. If you're a young man, go grab some fucking notes because you're about to hear it from the man who knows it all when it comes to this shit and knows more every day about it, okay? If you're a woman, come sit down. You're going to want to hear this, okay? Here's how you approach your crush. You first have to understand that the idea that they're going to like you for you is going to be a false idea. There is no you that they're going to like. You don't even know who the fuck you are. So get your emotions out of the way if you're going to approach somebody. If you want to approach your crush, you're getting all this emotion, right? Oh my God, they're so amazing. They're the greatest thing in the entire universe. Look at them. The first thing you got to do is not act out of that. If you act from that, you lose. Forget about it. Go to another video blog on how to handle your heartbreak. Okay? This one, how to get your crush. This emotion that comes up, okay? You cannot strategize from there. You cannot think from there, okay? So you're going to have to be strong enough to override that just at least a little bit. To do what? To pretend like that's not there. Man, you mean we have to start disgenuine? Yes, yes. If you're a man, here's my first advice to you. Don't approach her and tell her how you love her right from the beginning. She's going to be surprised, right? She has no idea how to even love. So now you're about to love her on one look. God made man, homo sapien male, fall in love like this. And God made sure the woman never fell in love. You get that? That was his plan. That's the only way. If you work it out genetically, why he would do something like that, okay? You and I, we're supposed to fall in love the moment we look at a woman. Oh my God, that's it. You're the one. For her, she's supposed to go through so many complications just to find out if you're the right guy. And this works out fine. But how do we approach our crush? We reverse it. If you're a guy, you don't just jump all in. You hold back. If you're a woman, he's already all in. You don't know that. Jump all in, baby. If you want a guy and you're a woman, my advice is jump all in. Go tell him, look, I want to be with you. Every guy runs away. No, listen. This is assuming that he likes you, right? If he likes you, then jump right in because he likes you more than you think he likes you, if he really likes you, okay? It's like you can never understand how much he could like you just off of not knowing you. He's a master at loving you from far away, okay? What you do as a woman is you find a guy who you're really into and then go all in. Don't go this slow route. You're fucking up, all right? For the guy, you got to slow down. And by her slowing down, I mean, by her speeding up and you slowing down, you come to a good medium because you're never going to slow down all the way and she's never going to jump in all the way. There's always going to be this little tug this way on her and this little pull this way from you. And so suddenly we come to the middle and then you shake hands. Hold each other's hand, baby, because you got to be in the middle of this whole thing. See, life swings on a pendulum like this. You know this alchemy law, right? It goes this way and it goes this way. It's day and then it's night. It's up and down, left and right, black and white, right? It goes like this. What you're supposed to do is you're supposed to somehow stay in the middle of it. But how are you going to stay in the middle of it? Ready? By becoming the observer and not the energy. So if I'm standing here watching this pendulum go like this, then you could say I'm standing in the middle of it because I see it when it swings up, I see when it swings down, and I don't swing up and I don't swing down. Now, in a relationship, once you establish that you're going to have this relationship with whatever it is, with, you know, an art form like martial arts, with a business, you have your career, your entrepreneur, or relationship, man or woman. Once you decide on what it is, then what you have to do is you have to literally step back and watch the pendulum of this relationship swing. Watch the pendulum of your business swing. The pendulum of your life, watch it swing. Because if you're inside of it, whenever there's a real up or a real down in your relationship, you're going to be fucking drowning like a motherfucker or flying, and you're going to have this very unstable life with each other. The stability comes from both of you recognizing that you're both outside of the problems of the relationship. Listen, it's very big. I thought I was talking to you how to approach your crush. We started like that. But hey, let's get into some real shit, right? Speaking of getting some real shit, you want to get onto the lion's den, okay? Go to arashzapar.com. That's my website. My program is 97 a month. So look, basically today is Friday, right? I'm going to teach from 10 to maybe 1 p.m. Definitely until 12, because that's when jiu-jitsu class is. If jiu-jitsu is canceled, I'm teaching 10 to 1 p.m. 11, 12, 1. Okay? Otherwise, I'm teaching till 12, like 11:50. The whole program is only $97. Right? So if you work that out into a month, it comes down to $3.24 a day that you as a man will spend on yourself. And how much money do you spend on them hoes? And fail. And how much money have you spent on just something trying to feel a little bit better? This is a group of men. The last count. Let's read it today together. It says, this is from Ebo, who works at Seductive Instinct. Good day, brother, at 5:17 a.m. Four people registered for Lion's Den. The total Lion's Den signups are 123. There you go. Super. Congratulations. So basically, it's $97 a month, okay? It's nothing. I teach 365 days a year, every day. Do you know why? Because it's more than that. I know that every man needs a place to come to. Sometimes your day is fucked up. Sometimes my day is fucked up. And there's nothing like getting around a bunch of warriors and watching them interact and tell their wins and successes and their trials. You remember who you are, okay? That's why we go every day, all right? And we go at 10 a.m. California, Pacific Standard Time, Pacific Coast, whatever the fuck it's called, PST. And what that means is that even if you're in Europe, you can still do it. We worked out that 10 a.m. here is a perfect time for everywhere in any country around the world. Anybody could come study for an hour at that time, okay? Hour and a half. Anyways, it's $97 a month. And it's very powerful. And it's only for men. It is not for women. Again, women are like, do you have a program for me? Yes, you're going to have to find Instagram, AZDIMC408 NorCal. Make sure it's L because people make fake ones like NorKai or Nor whatever the fuck they call them. Okay, and it's me and you'll be able to tell it's me right away. Okay, send a message there. I'll show you. I'll get you hooked up with the women's team. It's a whole women's crew, okay, taking place behind the scenes more. Okay, so anyways, let's get back to what we were talking about. Okay. This pendulum of life swings up and down. Some days you feel very energized. Some days you feel less energized, okay? Sometimes you're hungry. Sometimes you're not. Sometimes you're super inspired to work out. Sometimes you're not. And both of those days, your life is still running. And you're still the experiencer of all this. And the sooner that you could get a grip on who that is and what that is, the better you're going to be able to handle the swings. Because the swings are going to swing one way, then swing the other way. You're guaranteed the life is going to bounce between two poles all the time, okay, all the time. And so what you need to learn to do is to step away from it and see what's true or what's real. So in a relationship, you step outside of it and you realize that you have this thing together called trust. You have this thing called love. And that there could be good days or bad days, but the love must stay consistent, the trust must stay consistent. That's outside of the daily swings. Like loyalty is a quality that doesn't swing with the pendulum. It's not you're loyal when you're happy and you're disloyal when you're unhappy. That's what people's loyalty is these days, right? Mm-hmm. Loyalty is outside of the pendulum. And so any quality that's worth you and I spending our energy on, okay? Here's my challenge to you. Check it out. Isn't it true that any quality, any quality that's worth perfecting or getting better at should be a quality that's not in the pendulum, in the swing of things? Because if it is, we can get really, really good at it, and then suddenly the pendulum swings all the way the other way, and it makes no difference. In fact, we crash harder than ever before. So things like loyalty are outside of the pendulum. Love is outside the pendulum. Trust, honor, these big words that samurai and warriors used to live by, okay? That we still live by. The Stoics live by these words too. Justice, wisdom, these things are outside the pendulum. And so what you want to do in a relationship is you want to seek wisdom in the relationship. Make it a wise relationship. Seek love and trust. Now, how do you approach a woman if you can't jump all in? You have to understand, okay, that you're approaching her to demonstrate something to her. Are you ready for this? Here we go, planet Earth. You're simply demonstrating your intelligence and your resources. That's all the approach is. The approach is she's checking you for your intelligence. Really, more intelligence more than anything, because intelligence gives you resources on Earth. So it's a battle of wits in the beginning for her. She's going to test you. And she should try to test you because you're supposed to be more intelligent than her. You're supposed to be able to beat her in her stupid little games. She's not supposed to be able to manipulate you emotionally. If she can manipulate you emotionally, then another woman can manipulate you emotionally and you're toast. So she can't commit to you because she's committed to you. She gets older and older and older. She has a kid with you. And then a younger woman comes around and manipulates you emotionally and you drop responsibility. Like she's literally supposed to challenge you with her emotions while you keep your mind sharp and demonstrate your intelligence. Demonstrate your self-control. Demonstrate your wisdom. Demonstrate your power and your ability to walk away, which is your choice. If you do this, you will get any woman you want, I guarantee it. But you have to do it sharp, you have to do it well, right? You have to be groomed properly. Look, I know I look smooth, I look clean, right? I know that I've took the time to look like this today. So you have to have the intelligence also to see what you look like. Like you're not very intelligent if you look stupid and ugly. A lot of you smart guys that are like weird engineers, and I say weird engineers like you're so good with computers and you suck so bad with people. That's weird, engineer. You think you're smart. You're not. You're smart with computers and you're smart with spitting back data from a classroom. You're a dumbass because if you look in the mirror, you don't look okay. Right? You don't look like a successful human being, even though you're making a lot of money. You look like an unsuccessful human being. That means you're not intelligent enough to see yourself. So in the beginning, the battle between the man and the woman, their interaction in the beginning, I say a battle because it's a game. In the beginning, it's a game. You don't trust him. You shouldn't trust him. A woman shouldn't trust you. If you had a daughter, would you want her to trust a guy that approached her? Like, that's the dumbest shit I ever heard. So I'm not going to get offended if she doesn't trust me. I'll get offended if she trusts me. If she's like, yeah, where's your room at? I'm going to have a problem. She's a prostitute. Or she's in for something not good. She's definitely not somebody I want around. And you guys miss that. You miss that you're approaching a human being, a woman. And if she acts a certain way, you should actually have your alarms go off. And the way that she acts, where she plays harder to get, but still interested, that's what we're looking for. Right? Still interested, though. That's the approach. That's when you get to demonstrate your intelligence. Now, when you get into a relationship, you get to demonstrate your intelligence by being able to handle her problems that she's carrying. It doesn't mean solve them. It means be able to handle them. Like, listen, those problems, they don't hurt me. Right? That's part of the relationship that a man should bring to the woman. The woman should bring to the man anything that he's doing. she should try to make it greater. I'll give you a basic example. He's cooking something. She walks up, she goes, have you tried putting this, this, and that on it? And it makes his cooking greater. So it just starts with that. She walks into his house, she walks into his place, she goes, here, let me help you clean up, put this away, put that away. Let me make this place a little nicer, smell a little bit better. That's her making her, his place better. If she's listening to him work, or that's in my case, I'm speaking. So let's say if she's watching him work, she's contributing by giving positive energy during that time, not negative energy. How the hell did he open this? Okay.
Well, you must be a surprised man. See, I checked this.
Maybe that's how it happened.
Yeah, that one night, huh? Because there, it just happened right there.
Okay, I had to go. Boom. My puppy opened the crate. There we go. Now we know. Now I got to find out who changed the locks. And then we're okay. Okay, let's wrap this up now. So do you understand? There's so much, when I'm talking about it, there's so much intelligence involved in it, and I'm just barely beginning to touch the surface of it, okay? And when you see it in this manner, you see it properly. The other way you're seeing it is you're seeing it very emotionally. It's the same way you buy something. You buy it emotionally. It's the same way you do anything. Your emotions are the things that are pushing you and pulling you around. And so we try to practice what we do. When I say IMC warrior fighting monks, we study Stoicism as a basic philosophy. And then we get into the phase two, which is now what I'm kind of talking about every day. And you'll get to see how this philosophy in phase two, what it does is it pulls you out of it. You cannot be a reactive animal when you're done with phase two, because basically every reaction you have is a line, a string, like a puppet string that somebody has on you. Okay? And so that's what you practice. That's what your practice is as a man here. Right? You practice knowing that practice means you're going to fail a bunch of times. Like, I don't know how to play the violin. So if I picked up to practice it, it would sound like shit for a very long time. But I would practice trying to get better at it. Right? So that's what you do. You practice a state of mind. More than that, it's not a state of mind, really. You practice a state of being. You practice. And if you're that shitty at violin, if you've never done it before, imagine how shitty you're going to be in spiritual practice when you've never done it before. Mm-hmm. You're going to fucking fail like a motherfucker. But what you do is you use the old teachers, the people that have come before you, and you see in them the music how it should be played. And so you know it's possible because they've done it before you. Many have done it before you. They've put the same path. They walk the same path. So you go, okay, that's what it sounds like. I'm going to practice and I'm going to fail until I get there. And that's really the way you practice spirituality, okay? And that's what we do at IMC Nation. We practice spirituality. It's a spiritual motherfucking practice for the men and the fucking women. And that's what we do. We do nothing else. Why do you think I can get so many women? Why do you think I can make money the way I make money? Why do you think a hater can't touch me? Because the spiritual power is too much, motherfucker. Do you think I would even engage if it was some kind of an earthly power? I wouldn't even engage because there's always someone faster, always someone stronger, always someone more clever, something. There's no way I would engage with the world. I only engage with the world because I know I come from a spiritual point of perspective, a spiritual perspective, and I know it's untouchable. And I keep proving it again and again and again and again. And now I pass down the teaching, the tradition to others because that's what happens at a certain age. That's what you do. Everyone's done it. And so I'm doing it too. This is just what the fuck takes place. Okay? And then more people are able to do it. And during that time, your movement grows properly because it protects itself. If you're not teaching what you know all the way, then what happens is you get some movement like I did. When you start just letting it out and saying, everybody go, grab it and put it out. Then the next level of growth happens for a teacher because you can't just do that. You can't. You could even try it. You won't be able to do it. Okay? It's a thing that happens inside of you where the knowledge just takes over and it says, that's it. Now you're living for the existence of the knowledge. So you've evolved as a human being, for sure. I know I have, okay? Let's see what this is all about. It's patata. Okay, where do you find me? ArashZapar.com. Gentlemen, let's go. I'm looking for first 300 men. We're at 123. It'll be quicker than you imagine, okay? Be the first 300 because you ain't going to be the next 300 because it's only going to be one 300 on this thing, okay? So once we hit that, then I'm going to switch things up on everybody, all right? So try to figure out how to get there, be consistent. People will drop out, so the numbers go up and down a little bit in the end. But be there because I'm going to change the world with you 300, all right? Then after that, we'll figure out what we're going to do, all right? That's ArashThePower.com or find me on Instagram at AZDIMC408NorCal. Be the best, fuck the best, IMC Nation.